Hey everyone, welcome back to the channel. Hope you guys are having a great day. Now today we're going to talk about some Sony news that dropped yesterday, and you might as well just call this channel Oh No It's PlayStation, because of the fact that Sony has not stopped dropping a lot of news the last 2 weeks or so. But today is some good and some bad. Let's go with the good first. PlayStation invests in Discord and will integrate it into PSN. So Sony and Discord are getting into business together. Sony has announced a new partnership and will invest in the popular messaging and communication app, which will see Discord connect with your social and gaming experience on PlayStation Network. The integration between Discord and PSN is expected to happen in early 2022, though exact details on what it will consist of have not yet been announced. Sony president, "I've been really busy making these announcements," Jim Ryan said in a blog post that these teams are already hard at work bringing Discord to the PlayStation Network. "Together, our teams are already hard at work connecting Discord with your social and gaming experience, and our goal is to bring the Discord and PlayStation experiences closer together on console and mobile starting early next year, allowing friends, groups, and communities to hang out, have fun, and communicate more easily while playing together." Now, me personally, I would have liked to see Discord on every console, regardless of what it is. I don't know exactly how much they're investing into Discord. We're going to find that out in just a moment, I presume. But the thing is, I would rather see Discord happen across PC, PlayStation, Xbox, and the Switch. That would be the ideal scenario. We already use it as gamers so much in our everyday life, and communicating with people cross-platform as well as cross-play and cross-progression, I think is incredibly important. So personally, I don't really like the fact that they are locking it down behind the PlayStation Network or PlayStation in general. And honestly, I would say the same thing if Microsoft were to purchase Discord as well. I wouldn't want them to be fully under the fold and just locked away behind one specific console. I see this as a service that should be on everything, sort of like Spotify. I don't really think this would be a good idea in terms of, let's say, consumer advocacy would be the right way to do it. For just a communication platform to be locked behind a console or another proprietary box like that. Let's take a look and see what else happens in this article here. Sony also announced a minority investment in Discord as part of its Series H funding round. I'm guessing this was the one that Microsoft was going to be a part of in the funding. The figure attached to this investment was not publicly revealed. Okay. This comes just off the heels of a deal made between Discord and Microsoft to integrate the chat app with Halo Infinite on PC. And the two recently made headlines and reports circulated that Microsoft considered buying Discord for $10 billion. But Discord has decided to continue independently for now rather than pursuing a sale. Now this makes a little bit more sense. I think the whole idea was that Discord wanted to completely stay independent rather than be fully bought out. And Sony putting in a minority investment does have some stake in the company, but allows Discord to remain independent while having a cash influx come in, and that way they can still maintain, monitor, and run while having some sort of, let's say, war chest of revenues or profits sitting behind the bank. So that could be why they chose not to sell to Microsoft, is to stay independent, but we'll see what happens there. Hopefully, even though Sony has a minority stake, Discord will still show up on other consoles and we can all actually communicate together without having to play a console game and then also talk on your mobile phone through headphones connected to Discord on that end. I mean, that would just make things so much easier. Personally, that's how I would like to see it, but unfortunately these things happen like that. And yeah, if it is going to be proprietary, that could be considered to be something that is anti-consumer, because now you're locking away a free program that is used by everyone everywhere in order to, let's say, provide more value to your box that really doesn't have any other value on it besides your exclusives. But that's a whole other conversation we could have for another day. But with that, let's take a look at the comments section before we get to the next topic. What the fudge? So they won't sell anything to Microsoft but allow Sony to invest? Yeah, I think there's a really big difference between those two. Investing and selling would be a very big change of what they were actually thinking about. What's that? Can't you use Skype or something? I don't think anyone uses Skype anymore. Microsoft has rooted it into the ground. Yahoo! Effin' finally. I always love the community app on PS4. Now we got an even better app for social PS community. I've never really seen or played with a community app on the PS4 when I had one. I don't think it was that good from what people have been telling me though. Cool, Discord uses Azure. okay, I think you're just trying to cope. Keep up the copium, buddy. Just crank that lever. I really hope this sets up for cross-platform chat finally. Yeah, I think that's going to be hopefully what we go from there. So there's just going to add it on Azure like PSN then. So my Microsoft Discord deal fell through. Sure does. PS communities are coming back, sort of. Microsoft adds FPS boost to 74 games today. I'll take that investment over Discord. Okay, another fanboy. Take your copium. Take your copium. This explains why Discord did not hook up with Microsoft or get bought out. Sony trying to gobble up what gamers use now. I don't see this as gobbling up. I see this as, like they said, a minority investment. It could be anywhere between, let's say, 1 to 10% as a minority investor. You could also do something like 30 to 40% and still be a minority investor. I think what Sony has just done was put some money into Discord. And really what Discord probably did was shop around other places to see who would want to invest. Microsoft wanted to buy. Discord said no. Sony said, we'll give you some cash. I mean, Sony invested in Epic recently as well. So that could be what actually happened. I don't know if there's going to be any strings attached, but it may be showing up as priority on the PlayStation Network for Discord first. And then hopefully will show up on other consoles as well. But with that being said, let's go on to the next topic about Sony as well. And Sony really hated PS4 crossplay. Confidential documents have been revealed. This is by The Verge. Now, we talked about some kind of good news, and here is the bad news that we're seeing right here. It's no secret that Sony held back PS4 cross-platform play for years. But new confidential documents and emails reveal just how much Sony was against letting people play the same games with their friends on other platforms. Sony initially blocked cross-platform play for both Rocket League and Minecraft, despite Nintendo and Microsoft both enabling players to play across Xbox and Switch. The issue blew up when Sony blocked Fortnite crossplay in 2018, and players were obviously angry. It now appears that Sony may have been holding out to offset potential revenue losses. In the months leading up to Sony's decision to block Fortnite crossplay in 2018, Epic Games had pleaded with Sony to enable crossplay. Emails in the Epic Games versus Apple case reveal. Oh, here we go. I can't think of a scenario where Epic doesn't get what we want. That possibility went out the door when Fortnite became the biggest game on PlayStation, said Joe Kreiner, Epic's Vice President of Business Development. Here is Joe Kreiner's email. We love working with PlayStation and we want to be in a win-win. The longer this drags out, it will be less so. I can't think of a scenario where Epic doesn't get what we want. That possibility went out the door when Fortnite became the biggest game on PlayStation. Now, Epic has been using the leverage of Fortnite to, let's say, get what it wants for a few years now, and it seems to be working, especially against Sony. Against Steam, maybe not so much, but we'll talk about that another day. Joe then states, here's what I propose. We give you the data you're asking for, plus the marketing data ask. Epic deeply integrates Sony Esports API into UE4 as an engine-level feature. We market and advertise it as a first-class citizen of the engine. Maybe E3 announcement, and we support it in Fortnite. We announce crossplay in conjunction with Sony. Epic goes out of its way to make Sony look like the heroes. You get the pick when, where, how. Epic brands its E3 presence with PlayStation. We're planning a 100-player celebrity pro-am with huge after-party. Budgets I've seen are huge, and it will be the biggest event at E3. Maybe we announce with all the celebs on stage, new partnership, triple plus. Epic's willing to explore more items. Maybe we commit to a game at the launch of your next VR platform. PS Plus, maybe we do something with extra special for a month. Offer a unique character or something highly valuable to drive PS Plus adoption even more. Epic extends the Sony company-wide UE4 license. I don't think I mentioned this before, but your license to UE4 expires in May 2019. That is a little jab I've ever seen there. That license is some of the best terms we've ever offered for UE4. Let's make this huge win for us all. Epic's not changing its mind on this issue, so let's just agree on it now. Damn, he just went right for the killer jugular right there, boy. Woohoo! And it looks like Sony didn't agree. Gio Corsi, Sony's Senior Director of Developer Relations at the time, dismissed the idea of crossplay, noting that cross-platform play is not a slam dunk no matter the size of the title. Boy, was Corsi wrong on that one. A clear reference to Epic's flex about Fortnite's dominance on PlayStation. Gio, I think that one aged like milk, buddy. As you know, many companies are exploring this idea, and not a single one can explain how cross-console play improves the PlayStation business, said Corsi. And this is where we come to where the rubber meets the road. This is where we start to realize And ladies and gentlemen, these companies do not have your best interest, and they never have had your best interest. They only care about your pocketbook or about who they can invest in to then force you to open up your pocketbook. But as of August 2019, it appears that Sony may have found a worthy argument, a way to potentially siphon off money from its competitors in exchange to access for PlayStation players. The email correspondence doesn't reveal where the issue ultimately ended up, but a document entitled Cross-Platform Policy Requirements and Process from August 2019, after Sony's change, reveals how Sony may now approach cross-play, cross-platform revenue share, forcing publishers to pay Sony a royalty whenever PlayStation players contribute more than a certain percentage of the bottom line of a cross-platform game, to offset the reduction in revenue from Sony enabling crossplay. Look at how shitty this is. Sony is literally saying, if there are more people playing PlayStation, and every time you enable crossplay, you have to give us a cut of the share. You know, if there wasn't any more of a clear definition of being anti-consumer, I don't know what is. The fact that they're charging for crossplay and cross-progression access is honestly ridiculous across the board. This is a complete, we are a business model first and not a consumer model first mantra. I honestly didn't think Sony was this hard up for cash, but we do have some quotes from Epic's CEO Tim Sweeney, and he says, Tim Sweeney confirmed in testimony today that Sony is the only platform holder that requires this compensation for crossplay. The only one. In certain circumstances, Epic will have to pay additional revenue to Sony, said Sweeney. If somebody were primarily playing on PlayStation, but playing on iPhone, then this might trigger compensation. Sweeney also revealed that Epic had to agree to pay these additional fees to Sony in order to enable to crossplay in Fortnite. Sony also stipulates in the policy that publishers can't transfer virtual currency to or from PlayStation, and that there must be a setting to disable cross-platform interactions. There may have been good reasons for Sony to stop blocking crossplay as well. 3 months after the Epic Games emails, Sony was facing backlash when it blocked Fortnite crossplay, and it eventually backed down in late 2018 with a new policy change to enable crossplay in games. Now look, this is just unbelievable. Greed, money, corporate America. Let's be clear, that's on both sides here, but Sony is the only one charging. Seems like corporate Japan is just as much a part of this. Sony really hated PS4 cross. I'm not going to click the image, I don't know what it is. PlayStation has some really good exclusives, but Sony shouldn't get a pass because of that. It is first and foremost a corporation, and they don't care about gamers unless it means profit in some way. Thank you very much. When are people going to learn? Stop fanboying for companies. And the people that defended this and saying, oh, they should have never been crossplay or cross-progression in the first place, now you see why. You are literally just a wallet to be pried open and then have all your money sucked out as quickly as possibly can, because that's all they really care about. And if they don't get it from you, they're going to get it from somebody else, and then they're going to put the cost back onto you, and your experience is going to be even worse. Do not give these companies an inch, because they will always take a mile. And we'll go with the last comment here. It says, refurbished. Let this be a lesson for brand loyalty. These companies care about your money, not you. They aren't on the gamer's side. They are on the money side. So next time Sony gets on stage and says, we listened, what that really means is, shit, enough people care about this, and if we don't change our stubborn minds, we'll lose money. And that's exactly what happened. But anyways, y'all, that's enough Sony news for today. Hopefully, we get some different news tomorrow. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Do you think the minority stake in Discord was the right thing for Discord to take? And do you think Sony will keep Discord proprietary for PS5? And what do you think about Sony actually charging a fee for crossplay, dependent upon the fact that other companies do not off the bat? Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. If you like the content, please subscribe to the channel. It does mean a lot. Thank you so much for watching. If you want to see more, though, check me out on Twitch and Twitter. It's Alex. And if you want access to the Discord, the link is in the description down below. Thank you so much again for watching. Hope you guys have a great one, and I'll see you next time. Fucking bullshit! Son of a bitch! Bullshit!
Joe Hogan.